Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in financial accounting. And in this video, we're going to run through everything you need to know about income recognition, also known as revenue recognition, with a focus on how to account for this after the sale. We'll start off with a high-level overview of what revenue is and the revenue recognition criteria. Next, we'll dive into how we recognize revenue within the financial statements after the sale, using a couple of different scenarios as examples. Understanding how to record revenue is critical to the success of a business, so let's get started. Most businesses are looking to report as much revenue as possible in their financial statements because it sends the signal to its shareholders and creditors that the company is thriving. More revenue generally means the company is growing and bringing in more profit for the shareholders. However, there are certain circumstances where companies cannot record revenue at the time of the actual sale and have to wait until a future point in time to recognize it. In this video, we're going to focus on these types of scenarios, where companies are required to hold off on recognizing revenue until after the sale has already occurred. Now, before we get into the criteria, let's do a quick refresher on what is revenue. There are many different ways that a company can earn revenue. However, in basic terms, revenue is the amount earned when a company provides a good or service. In some cases, it's easy to determine when we can recognize revenue. For example, if I sell you my computer mouse for $25, as soon as I give you the mouse and you commit to paying me, I can record the revenue at the time of sale in my income statement. However, as we've mentioned, there are certain scenarios where the seller receives cash from the customers before they actually complete all of their obligations. For example, if I sell you an annual magazine subscription for an upfront payment of $120 a year, that's $120 of revenue in my pocket. However, the tricky part is determining the timing of when I can actually record this revenue in my financial statements. Can I record the full $120 as soon as I receive the cash for that annual subscription? Or do I have to wait until the full year passes? This is where the accounting rules come into play, helping to determine the timing of when the revenue can be recognized within the financial statements using the revenue recognition principle. Both US GAAP and IFRS require that revenue is recognized on the income statement in the period when it is earned, not necessarily when the cash is received. It doesn't matter how the customer chooses to pay. It could be cash, credit card, or even a commitment to pay in the future. As soon as the criteria have been met, the company can record the revenue. There's two general criteria for revenue recognition. The first is that the seller must have substantially performed its obligations to the customer, meaning the risks and rewards of ownership have been transferred. In the case of the magazine membership from earlier, this criteria has not been met at the time of the sale, since I'm obligated to provide you with a magazine each month for the whole upcoming year. The second criteria is that the seller must have either obtained monetary payment from the sale, or if they haven't received the cash yet, they must be reasonably certain that they'll receive payment. In this case, the criteria has been met, since I received an upfront payment of $120 cash for the annual magazine subscription. Now, since both of these two criteria have to be met in order to record the revenue, in this case, the company would not be able to recognize the revenue at the time of sale. Before we move on, let's talk about a couple common misconceptions. Revenue is not profit. Now, we need to remember that revenue is not considered to be profit. To calculate profit, first we must account for all of the company's expenses to reach the final profitability number. In the magazine membership example, where I sold you the membership for $120, I would likely have some marketing costs, employee payroll, and other administrative costs to consider before landing on profit. It's also a common misconception that we can automatically record revenue when cash is received. However, as we just saw, this is not always possible. So if that's the case, how would I go about recording the accounting transaction at the time of sale for this $120 annual magazine subscription? Since the transaction did not meet the revenue recognition criteria at the time of sale, this means that I would need to defer the revenue until a later date. However, remember that I have still received that $120 upfront payment, so we would need to record the receipt of cash in my financial records. The journal entry to record this transaction would be an increase or debit of $120 to the company's cash account and a corresponding increase or credit of $120 to the unearned revenue account. Unearned revenue, also known as deferred revenue, is the account we use to record funds when we receive them prior to providing the service. We can think of this $120 as a cash advance. Unearned revenue is a liability account because I still owe you the value of that $120 service until the time that I physically issue the magazines. So at this point in time, no revenue has been recorded. Which brings us to the next question, which is when and how can I actually record the revenue from this sale? If we go back to criterion number one, we remember that revenue can be recorded once the seller has substantially performed their obligations to the customer, meaning the risks and rewards of ownership have been transferred. In this case, this will happen in multiple steps over the length of the annual subscription. Since I'll be issuing one magazine each month for 12 months of the year, the revenue will slowly be recognized each month as the magazines are issued. Let's fast forward to the end of month number one, when the first magazine is issued. Step number one will be to calculate the monthly revenue. To do this, we can take the annual membership of $120 and divide it by the 12 months, which equals $10 per month. Now that we know our monthly revenue value, step number two will be to record the transaction with a decrease or debit to the unearned revenue liability account of $10 and a corresponding credit or increase to the revenue account of $10. By doing this entry, we have now brought down the total unearned revenue from $120 to $110 and subsequently recorded $10 worth of revenue in the company's income statement for that first month. This same journal entry would take place each month throughout the year, resulting in $10 of revenue recorded each month, so that by the time the end of the year comes around, that entire $120 worth of revenue will have been recorded. And that brings us to the end of the video. Remember, the ability to generate revenue is critical for the success of a business. For that reason, it's important that we understand the rules and criteria that determine when revenue can be recognized within the financial statements. The ability to grasp and implement this concept can have a significant impact on a company's financial reporting. If you're interested in learning more about this topic or many others, please feel free to check out our additional topics on Chegg.